I'm going to present our ongoing work in the area of natural language processing. Particularly, I'm going to talk about some of our preliminary work in learning semantic script knowledge with event embeddings. So before I talk about going into details, I would just like to motivate with an example. So consider the text written here. So you can see that there is someone going to the restaurant, and then he's eating, and then he's leaving. So is it possible to train a machine to expand this text and fill in the missing details? So for example, is it possible for a machine to tell what all goes on between entering the restaurant and before you start eating? So our work is directed towards making this possible, to get the sequence of events which would be taking place between, let's say, entering and eating. So now I would start with the concept of scripts. Scripts are a sequence of events describing prototypical human activities like cooking pasta or making coffee. So here you can see an example of eating in a restaurant script, and you can see the sequence of events that typically take place when you go to a restaurant for eating. So we refer this sequence of events as event sequence description, or ESD for short. So one peculiar thing about natural language is that there are more than one ways of representing the same concept or idea. So same is the case with scripts. You can see here that there are multiple ways of describing the same script eating in restaurants. So here you can see the three ESDs of eating in restaurant script. So by now you must have already guessed that scripts encode common sense knowledge about the world we live in, and if we manage to extract this knowledge, it would be quite beneficial for a lot of applications. And most of the earlier work focused on manual construction of knowledge bases for the scripts. So we ask the question, can we acquire this knowledge automatically from the text? So recent work on scripts has concentrated on representing scripts as graphs. So in this approach, all the ESDs corresponding to the script are taken and represented as a directed acyclic graph. So here the nodes correspond to event paraphrases or descriptions which are referring to the same event, and directed edges are the typical sequence of events that would take place in the script. Representing scripts as graphs seems attractive, but it has its own disadvantages. For example, it's the granularity of the node needs to be decided by the model designer, what should go into the node, predicate or the argument or both of them. Then it's not so easy to assign some kind of confidence scores to the event ordering. And then it's not entirely clear how to choose a graph to apply to a given test. So before I talk about our work, I will just let's see how scripts are typically used in applications. So scripts are used to answer a number of questions. For example, they are used to answer questions related to event ordering. So whether one event precedes another or not. Then they are used to answer questions related to event paraphrasing. If two phrases are referring to same event or not. And then they are used to answer questions related to a task or narrative clause where you are given a set of events and you are supposed to predict the implied event. So in this talk, I'm going to concentrate only on the event ordering part, and we propose a statistical model for event ordering. So here is the recipe for ordering the events. So we start with each ESD of a script. For each event in the ESD, we take the predicates, typically verbs, and the arguments, and we map them to the embeddings, and then we linearly combine them to get the event vector, and then we map this event vector onto a line using a weight vector. Once we have the scores for all the events in the ESD, we rank them to get the event ordering, and the ranking error is backpropagated through the network to update the values. So here is the model. Here you can see that we have the verb disembark and the arguments bus and passenger. We map them to the word embeddings, and then we linearly combine them to get the event vector. And once we have this event vector, we map it to a score using a ranking vector W. And when we have the scores for all the events, we order them and we backpropagate the ranking error to the network to update the parameters. So here you can see the learning objective. So we have the sequence of events for a particular ESG, and then the parameters that you saw in the model. And then we want to optimize this ranking hinge loss function, and we backpropagate the error to update the parameters. So here are some of the experiments on crowdsourced data. So we experimented on data collected by Gupta and Meshela Ragnari as well, using MSR Mechanical Turk. So here the event ordering task consisted of ordering a given pair of events, I mean to decide if one event precedes another or not. So here are the results for ordering. So we compared our model against frequency-based baseline. So here the ordering is decided by how often one event precedes the another in the text. So, and we compared our model against the two graph-based approaches. One was maximum sequence alignment by Ragnari et al., and another was non-parametric Bayesian method by Frevenen. And we had two versions of our model. One is without any arguments. Here, events only consists of only predicates and no arguments, and this is the full model. So you can see that our model substantially outperforms the previous methods. We did another experiment. This was on natural data. So we took the newspaper text from GigaWorld corpus, and we obtained the ESGs using a high precision rule based network classifier. This gave us the training set and the test set. And we trained on the training set. We trained on the training set, and test set was taken from a different news stories as compared to the training set. So here is the here are the ordering results. Here again we compared against a frequency baseline that I mentioned earlier, and then there is another baseline which is. Also frequency based, but here the frequency counts are taken from temporal classifier of Chambers and Jurafsky. And as you can see here again, our model has substantial improvement over the baselines. So we did another experiment with the natural data. So we divided the test set into three frequency bands. One was the this one is the zero frequency band. So the predicates seen in the this has the predicates which are never seen in the training data, and then this is the mid frequency band. So this is like predicates which are seen 1 to 10 times in the training data, and this is high frequency which has more than 10 the frequency is more than 10 times. So you can see here that our model performs pretty well, substantially well compared to other models, even for the cases which are never seen during training. So one thing that we noticed is that our model is able to learn non-trivial transitive relations. For example, if we know that event A is coming before B and B is coming before C, so the model is able to infer that A is coming before C. So now I would like to conclude. We saw a model for representing the representing and ordering the events, and we saw that it can easily outperform all the existing models. And we plan to apply this model for other tasks like causal reasoning, and we plan to apply this for other temporal classification. And we also plan to address other questions that scripts are used to answer.
So we have time for questions. one. So can your loss function handle situations where you have ambiguous ordering? So for example, if you think about getting dressed, there's a clear sequence for many of the operations involved, but there's certain things like, for example, where you put a socks on or a shirt on.
Yeah, so that's what, I mean, there were some cases, like you have different ESDs for a script. Some people give wrong ordering. So model, if, I mean, the majority of data is giving the correct ordering, model is able to recover.
So in your experiment, you talk about, you know, given the event, so you make the ordering. Whereas in the initial revision slides, you mentioned that you want to create the script.
Yeah, so, I mean, this is on, yeah, this is an ongoing work, so we are also working on the paraphrasing part and the derivative close part, right? So where we would be like generating the next likely event, right?
Okay, similar approach.
So so we have some ideas. Like one could be like we train, we have some kind of multi-lasting kind of approach where we train both the setups.
Okay, what if there's no more questions? Let's thank Dr. Tosh.